Hello everyone, welcome to Indian Judicial Service. Today we are discussing here question number 301 to 320. This is the part 17th of top 400 MCQ of Criminal Procedure Code. Those who have not watched our previous video, all the links of previous video available in the description box. If you like this video, please click on like button and share this video to your friends and other relatives. Now come to the question number 301. The withdraw of prosecution can only, so this is important here, withdraw from of prosecution. First of all, we are discussing here section number 321, withdraw of prosecution. So withdraw of prosecution is available, the section 321. Section 321 deal with the provision withdraw from prosecution. So who withdraw? So here two persons are available here. First one is PP, public prosecutor, and second here APP, assistant public prosecutor. These two persons are withdraw the suit or case. Now with the consent, they, when they are filing the withdraw application of the withdrawal, they can only withdraw the case in the consent. So second important point here, consent of court, consent of court. And third point here important, any time before the pronounce of judgment. So it is any time first, and before, any time before the pronouncement of judgment, pronouncement of judgment. And last important here point number 4, in respect of one or more offenses. So in respect of one or more offense, so one oblique more offenses. So what is the effect of the withdrawal from prosecution? So on the accused, if so, I write here effects of withdrawal. First effects is here, if the withdrawal is before a charge framing, if it is withdrawal before a charge, the accused shall be discharged. So in first point, if before the charge, accused shall be discharged. And if after charge framing here, after charge framing, so no, or if there is a no requirement of charge, there are two provision. First, after charge or the offense related, there is no charge, like a summon cases, there is no need of charge. So in such cases, the accused shall be acquittal. So these two points are very important here. First point, if there is a charge, so the accused shall be acquittal. And if there is a no charge, the withdrawal from the prosecution before the charge framing, so the accused will be discharged. There are some special provision there in this section, section 321, the provided. When the public prosecutor with the withdrawal the case in the consent of the court, in few exceptions there, if the case is related to the central government, if it is related to central government, the withdrawal of the case in with the consent of union government, if without union government it is not possible the withdrawal of the case. And if second point here, if the investigation is conducted by Delhi police, in same case the consent of the union government is required. And third important point is here, the damage of property of central government. If the offense is the damage of property of central government in same, so here important here, damage of property of union. So in this case, it is also the need the consent of the central government. And last, the offense is committed by the employee of the persons of central government. So these provisions are provided in section 321, the withdrawal by the prosecution. Now come to the question here. The withdrawal of prosecution can only be for all the accused person in case if there is more than one offense. Option B here, point 2 here. The withdrawal of prosecution can be in request of anyone or more of the offenses. Point 3 here, any one or more. The withdrawal of prosecution has to be in the respect of all offense as it is the withdrawal of the case. So in this question, option first and second correct, because the withdrawal of prosecution can only for all accused person if there is a more than one offense. And second point here, the withdrawal of prosecution can only be in respect of any one or more offense. And third point is wrong here. Why? Because the withdrawal of prosecution has to be in the respect of all offense as it is the withdrawal of the case. So it is here all offense. This is wrong here, because all offense are not there. There are some exceptions and many other things. Not possible the compoundable, because the list of the withdrawal is compoundable is also available in section 320. Now question number 302. The legal effect of withdrawal is, I already expressed this thing, the acquittal irrespective of whether the charge has framed or not. The acquittal when made after framing of charge, and charge if made before a framing of charge. Option C, discharge irrespective of the stage at which the case is pending. Option D here, either A or C. So answer is here option B, acquittal when the made after the framing of, so here acquittal made after the framing of charge, and discharge if made made before framing. So if there is, I already expressed this thing, if the withdrawal of the case before charge framing, the accused is discharged, and after charge framing, accused is acquittal. Now question number 303. Under section 315 of CRPC, an accused can not be a witness. Option B here, an accused can be compelled to give his own evidence generally. Option C here, an accused can be called as a witness only on his own request in writing. Option D here, either A or B. So in this question, answer is here option C, accused become a witness only on his own request in writing. Now question number 304. In a joint trial where several accused person are being tried, one accused examine himself as a witness now. All other accused, if there are more than one accused and other than the accused examine himself as a witness, have a right to cross examine the accused on a matter of right. Option B, all other accused have a right to cross-examine that accused if the accused is examine himself deposing something against one of the co-accused. Option C here, only that accused has a right to cross-examine the accused examine himself as a witness against whom such accuse has disposing something. This is very important. Option D here. The co-accused do not have any right at all to cross-examine. The accused examine himself as a witness under any circumstance. So in this question, option C is correct. The only that accused has right to cross-examine, the accused examine himself as witness against whom such an accused has disposed of something. So there is a very important section under section 315. The accused person is a accused can be competent witness. So this thing is provided under section 315. The accused is a competent witness. Now question number 305. An accused having made a request in writing to examine himself and have been called to examine himself must necessarily examine himself. Option B here. Has the liberty to give evidence without giving a rise of to any presumption against him. Option C here. Has the liberty to give the evidence but such a case the presumption against him arises. Option D here. Has the liberty not to give evidence but in such case the presumption as arises against him or other accused try along with him jointly. So in this question, answer is here option B. Has the liberty not to give the accused has liberty not to give evidence without giving a rise of any presumption against him. Now question number 306. The power under section 319 of CRPC can be exercised by a magistrate, the court of session, both, only after recording of evidence during the inquiry or trial. Option B, by a magistrate before recording of evidence, but by the court of session only after recording of evidence. First of all, we are discussing here section number 319. Now option number C, by a magistrate and the court of session both, even before recording of evidence. Now option C, D here, by a magistrate only after recording evidence but by the court of session before recording of evidence. So the power under section 319 of CRPC can be exercised by the magistrate and the court of session both only after recording of evidence during the inquiry or trial. So both magistrate and session court having a power, but after recording of evidence in inquiry or trial. Now question number 307. The magistrate has power to grant the compensation to victim as provided under section 360 of CRPC. Option B here. Section 390 of CRPC. Option C here. 358 of CRPC. Option D here. 357 of CRPC. So answer is here option 357 of CRPC. This is very important. This section is provided the compensation to the victim by the magistrate. And one another important section is there, 357A. This section is deal with the victim compensation scheme. So 357 deal with victim compensation scheme. Now question number 308. The compensation to the victim under section 357 of CRPC can be granted on conviction, acquittal, discharge, either A, B or C. So it is only grant, can be grant in conviction. Answer A here, option A. Now question number 309. Under section 357 of CRPC, the grant compensation to a witness can be passed by trial court, appellate court, revision court, either A, B or C. So here answer is option D, either A, B, C. Trial court, appellate court or revisional court can grant compensation to the victim. Option, question number 310. The compensation can be ordered to be paid under section 357 of CRPC when the fine does not form a part of sentence. Option B here, when a fine form a part of sentence. Option C, either A or B. Option D, only B, not A. So here answer is option B, when fine form a part of sentence. Question number 311. The disposal of property during the pendency of trial is governed. So here property is disposed by the court during the pendency of trial is governed under section 454 of CRPC, under section 451 of CRPC, under section 452 of CRPC and by section 453 of CRPC. So we are discuss here what provision of the in this section. First of all, we discuss here 451. So 451 is deal with the order for custody and disposal of property pending trial or in certain cases. So this is the answer of our question, because there is the disposal of property during the pendency of trial. So section 451 deal with the order of the magistrate and in custody and disposal of the property pending in trial in certain cases, according to section 451. Now deal with the question number 400, section number 453. 453 provided that the payment to innocent purchaser of money found on to accuse, on accuse, if there is an innocent purchaser, there is no guilty, there is no any mistake by the purchaser, so his property, his money found in the to the accused, so and after that the court is decided to deliver such property to the innocent purchaser according to section 453. Now question number 312. The disposal of property at the conclusion of trial is governed by, so conclusion of trial, option A 452, option B 453, option C 454, option D 455. We are already discussed this section 453. So in this question answer is here option A 452, the disposal of property at the conclusion of trial is governed by section 452. So this important section here 455 provided that the destruction of the libelous or the duty matter, like the defamatory matter, libel or slander. So these matters are destructed by the court according to section libelous matters and slander matters. Slander, the word is given by the speaking or some have acting, but in libel it is the printed or a picture, pictographic, etc. These are defame any other persons. So in this case the power of court to destruct these libelous matters and during the inquiry or trial, the punishment of this sections is available in IPC under section 292, 93, 501 and 502. So the label is restricted by code under section 455. Now section question number 313. The property within the meaning of section 451 of CRPC can be movable property, can be immovable property, can be movable or immovable property, and option D can be cattle only. So answer of this question here, option C, can be movable or immovable property. Now question number 314. The order passed under section 451 of CRPC is final order, interlocutory order, both A and B, either A or B. So it is, answer is here option D. No, this is, answer is here option B, because it is during trial. The word used here, during inquiry or trial, so it is interlocutory order, not final order. So option B is correct here. Question number 315. Application sex of section 451 of CRPC, the property must have been produced before the court during inquiry. Option B here, must have been subject matter of the offense. Option C, must have been used in commission of offense. Option D here, all of the above. So answer is here option D, all of the above. Now question, again I read here question. For application of section 451 of CRPC, so 451 provided that the order for custody and disposal of property depending trial in certain cases. So disposal of the property, so must have been produced before the court during the inquiry or trial. Option B here, must have the subject matter of the offense. Option D, have been used the commission of offense. So answer is here option D, all these things are available. Now question number 316. The provision for of judge and public servant are provided in option A 197 of CRPC, option B 179 of CRPC, option C 297 of CRPC, and option D 279 of CRPC. So it is clear here, the prosecution of judge and public servant is provided under section 197 of CRPC. Option A is correct here. Now question number 317. Under section 456 of CRPC, the prosecution of an immovable property, possession of immovable property cannot be restored at all, and a person has to restore to civil court. Option B, the possession of an immovable property can be restored only in case the person is convicted. Option C, the possession of immovable property can be restored even in case of person is acquitted. Option D, the possession of an immovable property can be restored in case of conviction, even though the finding of civil court are in favor of the person convicted. So first of all, I read here again section number 456 of CRPC deal with possession of an immovable property can be restored only in the case a person is convicted. So option B is correct here. Now question number 318. When the property is not produced before the court pending or during an inquiry trial, the disposal of property shall be governed by under section 454 of CRPC, under section 455 of CRPC, under section 557 of CRPC, under section 458 of CRPC. So it is governed under section 457. Answer is here option C. The 457 section deal with the procedure by police अपॉन सीजर और प्रॉपर्टी। नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 319, व्हाइल पासिंग एन ऑर्डर फॉर डिस्पोजल ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी, व्हेन द कोर्ट पासिंग अ ऑर्डर फॉर डिस्पोजल ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी, मजिस्ट्रेट हैज टू डिसाइड द क्वेश्चन ऑफ टाइटल। नो, द क्वेश्चन ऑफ टाइटल डिसाइडेड बाय द सिविल कोर्ट। द मजिस्ट्रेट हैज टू डिसाइड द क्वेश्चन ऑफ एन टाइटल ऑफ पजेशन विदाउट डिसाइडिंग टाइटल, दिस इज करेक्ट हियर, ऑप्शन सी हियर। मजिस्ट्रेट हैज टू डिसाइड द क्वेश्चन ऑफ टाइटल एज वेल एज द क्वेश्चन ऑफ एन टाइटलमेंट ऑफ पजेशन एंड ऑप, सो इट इज ऑल्सो रॉन्ग हियर, देयर इज नो टाइटल, ऑप्शन डी। द मजिस्ट्रेट हैज टू डिसाइड द क्वेश्चन ऑफ एन टाइटलमेंट ऑफ पजेशन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द डिसीजन एज टू द क्वेश्चन ऑफ टाइटल, सो इट इज क्लियर हेयर, ऑप्शन बी इज करेक्ट हेयर। द मजिस्ट्रेट हैज डिसाइड द क्वेश्चन ऑफ एंटाइटलमेंट ऑफ पजेशन विदाउट डिसाइडिंग द टाइटल, बिकॉज द राइट ऑफ डिसाइडिंग द टाइटल इज सिविल कोड। नाउ फाइनल क्वेश्चन ऑफ दिस वीडियो, क्वेश्चन नंबर 320, अंडर सेक्शन 459 ऑफ सीआरपीसी, द मजिस्ट्रेट मे ऑर्डर फॉर अ सेलिंग ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी बाय द गवर्नमेंट एंड इफ no claimant appear, if there is no claimant within 3 months of, within 6 months, within 1 year, within 3 years, so according to section 459, this section follow the provision of, this section follow section 459 follow the provision of, the provision of section 457 and 458. So 457 subsection 2 provided that the sale of property, so sale of property, which type of property, movable or immovable, both type of property, provided that the sale of property, sorry here property not provided property property 6 months from the date of proclamation, so it is here clear, 6 months from the date of proclamation, so this is the provision provided under section 457 and section 459 follow the rule of section 457 and 58. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, click on like button. Thank you for watching.